it's going to be a pretty hostile environment. They're going to come out fighting, playing really aggressive. You can expect that. And you just got to be ready for any and everything and try to, you know, get off, like I said, get off to a good start, give ourselves a lot of momentum early.
What did you think of the All-NBA teams? You and Kevin on second, Draymond on third?
You know, obviously appreciative of that positioning. Knowing a lot of guys had great years this year, and we can go down the list and talk about each one individually. So it is nice to be recognized in some way, shape, or form. Obviously, we have bigger fish to fry. We're trying to win a championship. And you could obviously shout out Clay in his season. Definitely deserve to be on one of those teams. I know it's obviously a tough vote every year to figure out, you know, who goes where, but that's a guy that, you know, played and had an amazing season. He's very consistent all year long, so definitely deserve to be on that spot.
I think in terms of those teams, Clay doesn't really get enough credit for his defense. Even though he has not been shooting well in the series, I mean, he's been doing pretty good.
We understand what Clay brings, and if it's unheralded or whatnot, or if, you know, people don't notice it, or what, we appreciate what he brings to the floor every single night, and we'll be the ones to praise him and to lift him up if need be, because he deserves that recognition for, like you said, his impact on both ends of the floor. You can fall in love with his jumper, you can fall in love with, you know, 70 or 60 points in three quarters or whatever, but you know, he does bring an all-around game that is impressive. It's something he's, I know he takes pride in.
He's had some really good games on the road. I mean, obviously, Oklahoma City last year, but he's had some big games in San Antonio. You shoot at home, shoot on the road. I mean, there is a difference, I would imagine. Why is he such a good shooter on the road? What type of mentality do you have to have to be a good shooter on the road?
I mean, it's confidence, but really, you don't think about nothing, really. Like, you expect to make shots. You expect to shoot well no matter what zip code you're in. But that's what shooters, you know, that's how we think. And the only difference is just the noise after a shot goes in. Whether it's in, you know, 18,000 fans screaming or it's dead silence. So, that's pretty much it. You shoot the same shots, you have the same aggression. But you don't really think about the difference really at all, because when you have the ball in your hands, that's what we love.
No, Arena, where you say, I just really hate shooting here.
There are some, and I've still been trying to figure out how to explain it. Like, there's depth perception situations. There's lighting. Rims are softer in certain cities. The humidity and how the ball feels in certain cities. I love shooting in Miami because it's like sticky because of the humidity down there. You have a better feel for the ball. The opposite of that is like playing in Chicago. We go in like, you know, December, January, February months, and it's freezing cold, and the ball doesn't really warm up. That's kind of tough to get used to. That's the little things you kind of notice.
Right.
But at the end of the day, when you get in that moment, and you have the ball in your hand, I'm not thinking about that. And I'm sure Clay isn't either, or any great shooter isn't. It's just shoot the ball.
Steph, I read in a book recently where Clay's performance in Game 6 meant something to you. You kind of said, go do it for a little while.
That was a good book, wasn't it?
I don't know.
It was a good book.
It was all right.
I heard it was golden, right?
Yeah, it was golden. That's what somebody said.
That's what
somebody said. He owes me some money now for just saying
that. Yeah, exactly.
What was that?
You want to bet, though? Oh, okay. Written by Marcus Thomas. A great book, man.
Goodness.
Great book.
Jeez.
Great book.
Wow.
I should
withdraw the question.
No.
Did Clay's performance in that game kind of change, not change, but elevate him in your mind? Like, okay, now he can go do it on the biggest stage.
Always that confidence that from like 2013 when we played in San Antonio. Game one, we had a, obviously, I remember the story, we had a great big lead. I played well in game one, ended up losing that lead, and Manu hits a three to win the game. We come back game two and play with this gunslinging. It was unbelievable, the way that he impacted that game, shooting the ball and having a huge night. So you knew he was capable of it even from early in his career. And anytime you can play well on the biggest stage, it just is, it's amplified. You know, tenfold for everybody who's watching it, you can feel that moment. So didn't prove anything to us. Obviously, we appreciated the effort, and that was something that was truly special. But we expected him and know he has that in him at any point.
You remember anything special about that game, a moment when you went, man, Clay's got it going?
Probably, I think the beginning of the fourth quarter, he hit one on the top of the key from about 5 or 6 feet beyond the three-point line, and his feet were, like, facing our bench, and he just, you know, just shattered. That's when those kind of heat check ones, you know it's gonna be something special.
So, if you should have thought some of the season awards being presented on the show,
I have mixed feelings about it, honestly, because having come celebrate my MVP last 2 years with the traditional way, I guess you call it, I really enjoy just being at home and celebrating that moment with the people that helped me get to that place, my teammates, coaching staff, the fans, that next home game. The staff, everybody that's a part of the organization gets to feel and enjoy that moment. So that is a special thing. And whoever wins it this year isn't going to be able to do it right away in front of their fans and enjoy that. So that's the only part that I have kind of mixed emotions about, having to wait so long to understand or to hear who won. And it would just be a different way to kind of celebrate that moment for whoever that person is. I'm sure it's going to be a great show. I'm sure it's going to be fun for fans and everybody to kind of look back at the season as a whole at one time. But, Defensive Player of the Year, Sixth Man of the Year, MVP, those moments that you have on the floor, fans going crazy. Like I said, you get to enjoy it with the people that helped you get there. That's a special moment that if you have to wait so long, it's kind of different.
Last question. Sounds like
he said over the course of this season he's developed a thicker skin and let things kind of roll off his back after taking so much scrutiny at the beginning of the year from fans. Have you seen that? Does that better prepare him for maybe the kind of treatment he could face Saturday?
Zaza's got a thick skull, so I know when he gets out there, he's going to be able to play. I know the guys in the locker room have told him, like, block out all as best you can, obviously block out as much of this noise as possible, because it doesn't matter. We know what kind of person you are. You don't have to be apologetic for Kawhi about what happened, but you don't have to apologize for your intent on how you're guarding that play, whatever you want to call it. So moving on, he's going to be, he'll be ready, he'll be same Zaza, confident, and that's what we expect, and he knows that we have his back. Hopefully that'll go a long way.
Were you one of the guys who said it to him?
Yeah, I talked to him.
Okay.
I don't think he needed to hear it, but just knowing that we all have his back is something huge, and just especially at this juncture with the spotlight and the microscope that everybody's on.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
You caught that? Yes.
Me too.
Thank you.